morning, dear students. In the last class, we have discussed about an activity. We read a listening passage about Sankalpa and his Sankalpa. Sankalpa concept was completely different about education. According to him, education means, learning means, always reading books and by heart the questions and answers. But according to the headmaster, the education means learning nature, study the nature, and also students should be able to express what they understood. That is the learning, or that is the education according to headmaster. So the headmaster and Sankalpa's views are different on education. Okay. So let us discuss about the lesson or day in the after in today's class. So I would like to introduce about the author of the lesson or day in the after. So you know the plan. Who is the author of the lesson? C.F. Andrews. C.F. Andrews. C.F. Andrews is the author of the lesson, A Day in the Ashram. Yes, what is C.F. means? Charles Free Andrews. His full name is Charles Free Andrews. Charles Free Andrews is the full name of C.F. Andrews, who is the author of the lesson A Day in the Ashram. So he was born on 1871 and he was died on 1940. He was born on 1871 and he was died on 1940. So he was an English priest of the Church of England. He was the English priest of the Church of England. He was a British people. He was a British man. So, he was working as a priest of the England Church. Priest of the England Church. He was an educator and also an Indian freedom fighter. Charles Free Andrews was an educator and also a freedom fighter of India. Freedom fighter of India. So you have a doubt. I think you have a doubt. So Sir Charles Free Andrews belongs to England. How can he fight? How would he fight in favor of India and against of Britain or England? There was a reason why C.F. Andrews fight in favor of India and against of England, because Charles Free, he was a Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhiji's closest friend and also a associate. He was a close friend of Mahatma Gandhiji and also a associate of Mahatma Gandhi. He was a close friend of Mahatma Gandhi and he worked as an associate. Associate means assistant. Associate means assistant. He worked as an assistant of Mahatma Gandhi and also in the meantime he was a close friend of Mahatma Gandhiji. He was influenced by Mahatma Gandhiji. He was influenced a lot by Mahatma Gandhiji. Then he joined his hand with Mahatma Gandhiji to fight. fight against the British. So that's why Charles V. Andrews of C.F. Andrews is considered as freedom fighter of our country. We should feel proud about C.F. Andrews. We should feel proud about C.F. Andrews because C.F. Andrews was an English person, Indian person. So, what he fight against the England to bring the freedom to our country. So, he was a close friend of Mahatma Gandhi and also an associate means assistant or alias helper of the Mahatma Gandhi. Here, C.F. Andrews reveals his experience. Release means publish. Release means publish. Here, he reveals. Release means publish. Here, C.F. Andrews reveals his experience while staying in ashram. Here, one day, C.F. Andrews stayed in the ashram. What the experience he had in the ashram? So he reveals his experience. How was the ashram? How was the day in that ashram? How was the day in that ashram where he stayed in that ashram? Or how was the ashram? How were the classes held in the ashram? Everything he discusses. And he reveals his experience in the lesson and in the ashram. Yet the ashram is Shantiniketan. Ashram is Shantiniketan. Ashram is where C.F. Andrews stayed one day. The ashram name is Shantiniketan. The Shantiniketan ashram was founded by our national poet Rabindranath Tagore. Have you heard about Rabindranath Tagore? Do you know about Rabindranath Tagore? Yes, he was the poet of our national anthem. He was the poet of our national anthem. Okay. So, Rabindranath Tagore, he was the poet. Rabindranath Tagore, he was the poet of our national anthem. He was the poet of our national anthem. So, we should feel for our Rabindranath Tagore and we consider him as a national poet. We consider him as a national poet. So, one day, C.F. Andrews visited Shantiniketan. And he stayed one day in the ashram. What were the experiences he got in the ashram? He published his experience in the lesson and in the ashram. So, the Shantiniketan ashram is a school. Shantiniketan ashram is a school. The school is different. Shantiniketan school is different where students learn with great joy. There is no threat on the students in Shantiniketan. There is no restrictions. There are no limitations. There are no punishments in the Shantiniketan school. Students are enjoying the learning. Students are enjoying in the school and they are learning with great joy. They are learning with great joy. So that's why that school is coming. And after we know that one mean they don't have any options to go out of the classroom. You will be respected in the classroom. But in Shanti Ketan, they are very free. They are learning with great joy. You are learning with great pain in the classroom. Am I right? No? You are also learning with great joy. That I know. So, Rabindranath Tagore, he founded the Ashram. The Ashram name was Shanti Ketan. It is a school. School. It is a school with difference. Because the students are learning here with great joy and they are enjoying the learning. So, this is the brief reflection about the sea of handbills. So, shall I go into the lesson? Yes. Dear students, come to the page number 2. Adi in the ashram. Words cannot picture to you the beauty of Shanti Niketan. Our old poet and teacher, whom we call Gurudeva, has named it in his song, The Darling of Our Hearts. And it is worthy of the name. All who have visited the ashram, old and young alike, have felt its inner beauty growing more and more upon them. If I were to describe to you one day in the ashram, with the boys, that would perhaps best bring home to you its inner beauty. Long before sunrise, like the birds in our own Amroki groves, our boys are hungry. The tourists are the first to rise and they go around the ashram. Singing in the morning time, you can hear the voices in the distance, drawing near and nearer, and then the sound dies away as the rope passes on to another part of the ashram. And then again it comes nearer and nearer. The beauty of the sound in the silent morning air and the sense of joy and reverence which it brings give peace to the soul. Dear students, I will take only one stanza. Okay. So, I would like to write the new words. Okay, you can note down new words. Here the word is Gurudeva. Yes, whom we call Gurudeva? None other than, yes, Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore is called as Gurudeva. Inner. Inner means internal or natural. Internal or natural beauty of Shanti Ketan. Okay. So, and dear students, I would like to introduce present form verbs and also past form verbs. You can concentrate on them. Present and then past. Present and then past. Here I will take name. Here in the present tense, the verb will be name. So it will be named in the past tense. Okay. So then visit. It will be visited in the past tense form. In the present form, feel. In the past form, felt. Okay. You can connect other words also. Okay. So present form was name. In the past form it will be name. In the present form was visit, it will be visited in the past form. Feet, it will be felt. Okay. Then you can go through them like describe. Okay. So bring, brought. Maybe in the present form bring, the past form brought. Okay. Are you understanding? The word form will be changed in different tense forms. The verb form should be changing different tense forms. So, some words will be same in different tense forms. Okay, I will introduce them later. So, dear students, words cannot picture to you the beauty of Africa. Words cannot picture to the beauty of Africa. That is means we cannot explain the beauty of Shantiniketan in our words. It is behind our words. The beauty of Shantiniketan will be behind our words. So, we cannot say the beauty of Shantiniketan in our words, or we cannot explain the beauty of Shantiniketan in our words, because we cannot describe the beauty of Shantiniketan in your words. We cannot describe the beauty of Shantiniketan in your words, because the beauty of Shantiniketan will be behind our imagination, will be behind our explanation, will be behind our description. Dear students, maybe I think all of you like rose. Especially you like to have a red rose. The red rose will attract us. Red rose will attract all of us. My question is, can you explain the beauty of that? Yes. Do you agree that red rose has red rose as a beauty? Yes. Do you agree the red rose as a beauty? Yes. The red rose as a beauty because it attracts us. Yes. Can you explain the beauty of red rose in your words? Is it possible to? Yes. Maybe you can. Yes. The red rose is looking very beautiful. And it is completely redden. It attracts us. I want to have it. You can explain it in any way, but you cannot completely explain that you love red rose. I will get a joke first. I think the joke falls will attract each and everyone. There is a beauty in joke fall. As those who have visited the joke fall, they can enjoy the beauty of joke fall. They can enjoy the real beauty of joke fall, especially in the rainy season. Okay, those who do not visit the joke fall, if I go to explain the beauty of joke fall, if any word I can use to explain, we cannot understand the beauty of joke fall. When you go and visit the beauty of joke fall, then you can understand the beauty of joke fall. Like that, we cannot bring maybe. Maybe I am explaining about the beauty of joke fall. Instead of explaining the beauty of joke fall, if I show the picture of the joke fall in my mobile, easily you can understand the beauty of joke fall. Okay. If I go to explain the beauty of Taj Mahal, you cannot understand the beauty of Taj Mahal. If I go to show the picture of Taj Mahal in my mobile, easily you can understand. That is the meaning. We cannot explain the beauty of Shantiniketan in the words. Words cannot picture the beauty of Shantiniketan. If you want to understand the beauty of Shantiniketan, you have to go and visit it. You can understand. Okay. So, words cannot picture to the beauty of Shantiniketan because Shantiniketan's beauty is beyond our imagination. The beauty will be beyond our words. Beyond our describing. Our own poet. Who is our own poet? Yes, none other than Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore is considered as our own poet. Rabindranath Tagore is considered as our own poet. And we call him as Gurudeva. He was not only a poet, and also we accepted him as our teacher. Rabindranath Tagore, not only a poet, we accepted him as our teacher. So, He is our own poet and our teacher. We call him as Gurudeva with love. We call him as Gurudeva with love. Gurudeva is the pet name for Rabindranath Tagore. Gurudeva is the pet name for Rabindranath Tagore. We accepted him as our own poet because he wrote our national anthem. He wrote our national anthem. So, we call him as Gurudeva. Rabindranath Tagore as named Shantiniketana in his song, the darling of our hearts. What did Rabindranath Tagore name Shantiniketana in his song? Rabindranath Tagore named Shantiniketana in his song as the darling of our hearts. The darling of our hearts. He named it as the darling of our hearts. He named it as the darling of our hearts. So, because the darling of our heart, you don't confuse by hearing the word darling. Yes, maybe we use the word dear. Yes, my dear father, my dear daughter, my dear brother, my dear friend. Maybe the movie, the film people are using the word darling in a bad manner. But the word darling is a fantastic word. Your father can call you as darling. My darling, my daughter is my darling. Whom we call as darling? Whom we love so much. Whom we love so much we call you as darling. This house is my darling. This God is my darling. My father is my darling. Because you have a lot of love on your father. You have a lot of love on your mom. Lot of love on your house. This is my darling. You can call your vehicle. Buy a car. This is my darling. Because you love so much your car. Again, bulk. So, we love so much the duty of Shantiniketana. So, that's why this is a darling of the beauty of Shantiniketana as the darling of our hearts. Rabindranath Tagore named the beauty of Shantiniketana in his song as the darling of hearts because we have a lot of affection. Rabindranath Tagore has a lot of affection. He has a lot of affection on Shantiniketana. He loves so much the beauty of Shantiniketana. That's why he called it as is on the darling of our hearts. It is not only a darling of our hearts for Rabindranath Tagore, it is the darling of our hearts, the whole country people. And the name, it is worthy of the name. The darling of our hearts, and it is worthy of the name. What's the name we kept for the school, Shantiniketana, for the classroom, that is worthy. That is worthy to that name. All who have visited the ashram, those who have visited the ashram, even not only old people, even young people were also visited the ashram. Their faith is in the beauty. They are completely flattered by the beauty of. They are flattered by the beauty of Shantiniketana. Who have visited the ashram? Who have visited the ashram? Old and young people. Old and young people. Those old and young people who have visited the ashram, their faith is inner beauty. difference between the natural beauty and also the artificial beauty. We cannot make out the beauty of Joe Cox artificially. We cannot make out the beauty of nature artificially. If we do the artificial nature, that will be dummy against the natural nature. Natural is natural, artificial is artificial. Okay, so the people who have visited the Shantiniketan, they felt in the beauty, and the beauty is growing more and more upon them. They are completely flattered to the beauty of Shantiniketan, and they wanted to see Abhinand again. Already I told you, those who have not visited the Joe Falls, once you visit the Joe Falls will attract you again and again. That may be some historical places are there, some parks are there, some temples are there. They will attract us often, frequently, because we want it. If many people, they will visit the Dharmasthala often. We visit the fort, Chitradurga fort, often, because it will attract. We visit the Mysore Palace often, frequently, because it will attract us. Like Shantiniketana, the beauty of Shantiniketana also attract us to visit frequently, often. That type of beauty it has. That type of beauty it has. So, that's why those who have visited the ashram, old and young people, so it is attracting them. And it is attracting them. So, that means what we call glass, which thing we like, the thing will attract us frequently. That the beauty of the thing will attract us. Okay. So we will defeat in front of the beauty of the thing. That type of beauty can be among us. Okay. I hope we are going to understand the passage. Okay. So now I am going to give a homework. Okay. You can now write down the homework, then can answer the questions. So I will write down the questions on the blackboard. You can write them in your rough book.
Is from the fifth one. in the ashram.
Okay, dear student, I hope you understood today's class. And also, I hope you did answer all the questions. Okay, once you read the lessons, then you go to try to understand yourself. Then you go to write the answers. Okay, so yes.